Steve Dotto here, and today we have a good one for you. Team and task management. Virtual team and task management. You know, there's nothing more important to the success of small businesses and even large businesses is communication, making sure that we're all on the same page, working in the same direction. Well, that challenge is enormous when maybe we don't work for the same company or we work in different time zones, different offices, different countries. So finding tools that help different project teams work towards the common goal, that's a very important piece of the whole productivity equation. Now, there are a lot of different tools that people can use and a lot of different techniques they can use, but the one that I'm really enamored with these days is one called Asana. It is free for up to 30 users, and you can buy the premium version, which gives you some additional features. But the free version alone is an exceptionally capable task management tool designed for collaborative team environments. Now, I was first actually shown Asana by a friend of mine, Mike Vardy, who former editor of Lifehack. He's got this great article. I'll post a link to the article on why he chose Asana as the tool of choice for him. It's a good overview of what Asana gives you versus what some of the other different tools give you. So let me take you on a quick little tour of Asana and see if it might not fit in your life. So Asana is a web-based tool. You can use it most of the time. You're just going to use it in your browser interface. There is an app which you can install on your iPhone, which I'll show you a little bit later. But for the most part, it's a complete web 2.0 tool that you can access through your any web-enabled device. So it crosses all platforms because of its web capabilities. Now, how they basically set it up is you set up yourself as a user, sign in for free, and then you have both personal and different business profiles that you work within. And you can see here that I've got my dottotech profile, which is my main work profile. And if I click here on the profile button, I can actually switch over to my different personal projects. So I can keep all of my different to-dos in one place. Now, this is really important because what happens is all the different projects that I'm working on with different groups of people that aren't necessarily related to each other, they all flow into my own personal task list. You see here, here's my different tasks. Some of them are related to projects that I'm working on with other people, and some of them are just my own projects that I have as my own to-do list. It's really important as you plan your day and as you do different things to be able to see a snapshot of all of your responsibilities at once. I really like this feature within Asana. As we move in, let's just take on, let's look at a team project that I'm working on. I've got this productivity. We're doing these seminars where we're teaching people about different productivity tools. So I work with several other people on that. So what happens is we each have an account in Asana and we then share this particular project, this productivity team tasks. We are all on the team. And as different people assign different tasks, they can be assigned here from this administrator panel. If we want to add a new task, I just hit the enter key and that creates, as we see right here, a new task. Now, a task that needs to be done on this particular project, we have to set up our Facebook and LinkedIn advertising. So I'm going to put in just Facebook ads as a task. And here's how I assign it. As I click here, and I say this can be assigned to me or to somebody else within my team. And it's that easy to designate who is responsible for any of these tasks. Now, I'm going to assign this task to me because I work harder than anybody else. And if we look over here on the right-hand side, now we have a detail on that particular task. I can give it a due date. I can create subtasks on it. So we can, if we, for example, in this one here, we might have subtasks. The first one we have to do is create graphics for the new ads. Create graphics. You know, I hate those little tiny Facebook ads and LinkedIn ads. We've got to create those graphics. So I've been working on those, so I'll put that down as a subtask. And you can see that we are now building a nice tree of responsibility and making sure that this particular task is accomplished. I can, as I said, put in due dates. I can add tags. I can even do things like attach different files to it. I can attach them from Dropbox or from my computer. I've been working on some of these ads myself, so I say I can add that graphic to the task so team members can look at it, and maybe I'm asking people's opinion on which ads do you like and which ads don't you like, and there's that ad, and they might say, oh, Steve, the text is too small. It gives us all of the different resources we need in one place as we work our way through the project. Of course, what task list wouldn't be complete without some success? So once a project is complete, you can click on complete. So we have a visual representation of how we're proceeding on our different tasks on the project. Now, we have a choice of just working within this environment here or having Asana reach out to us and touch us and tell us what we're supposed to be doing in other ways. If I go down here into the very bottom left-hand side, this is your kind of your account administrative area, and I'm going to go there. I'm going to go into account settings, and there I can choose how my account is managed. Most importantly for us is, do I want to have all of my different tasks emailed to me each day and be reminded of them, or do I want to just deal with it within Asana? That's a personal choice. You can set it up any way you want. You know, while I'm down there, I want to mention one other area. You see here it says new workspace. What Asana does is they deal with each of your kind of identities as a workspace. So if you have a corporate identity where you want to have all of Asana within your business, but you might also maybe want to use Asana for managing a softball team, that, you know, managing all the different tasks on a softball team or something recreational, you can set up a new workspace so that you can demark all of those tasks away from one workspace to the other, and another workspace, but it allows you to have all of your personal tasks still flow into your own personal window. It's actually pretty creative how they've set that up. Now, the other thing that we see here is this whole management panel here on the left-hand side, which has all of our different projects, tags, which will allow us to create better organization, and all of the different people that we work with in whatever workspace we happen to be working in. But doing tasks and task management is pretty efficient while you're on your computer, but it'd be silly to think that we just spend our whole life on our computer. We come up with ideas, we come up with things that need to be done, we do things when we're out and about moving. So Asana also has a pretty good iPhone app. Actually, it's a very good iPhone app. And let me call it up and see if I can show it to you. I'm actually quite impressed with how that app works. So here is my iPhone. And I go into my productivity section there on it. And here is my Asana. When I open Asana, we can see that I've got the same basic management tools as I have in the web version. Here's all my different workspaces. Do you recognize it? It looks almost the exact same. Let me just go back quickly into my into the web browser version. And let's open up Asana. And there we see all of the same tasks. Actually, let me get my face out of the way. And let me just put this side by side so you can see that I've got all of the different workspaces here. And then I just close back, and there are all of my tasks listed out. Now, if I add a new task into the productivity team task area, I tap on the plus button, I can type in the new task here on my iPhone, and then I create that task. Now, you see that it's in the protect area here as far as it's the project there, and if I want to switch which project it's in, I can do it there, but I'm going to leave it in that project. New task, and I'm going to create it. And now it creates it on my iPhone as a task. We can see right here. And then, as soon as I sync up here, look how quickly. It's already done it online, and it's added the new task here within the web browser as well. Asana is really worth taking a look at. I've only scratched the surface of the capabilities of this particular program. For team management in teams up to 30 people, which for most of us is the preponderance of our projects, you can try it for free, use it for free, and you may never need to upgrade. I haven't upgraded myself, and I wonder what wonderful things I'll discover should I choose to upgrade. Asana free, online, check it out. I hope you found this video useful. If you have, please give us a like, show us some props, and thank you very much for joining us here on dottotech.